Hi, good afternoon, and welcome to our Spring Cleaning Naturally Workshop. This is day number one, and we're starting in the bathroom. These are the most frequented used rooms in my house, except for my mudroom, and a lot of times I just dread the bathroom. Well, let's go ahead and conquer it with some natural cleaners, and we'll start with the toilet. I'll tell you for my toilet what I like to use the most is a good scrub with some baking soda. And the other thing that makes a big difference is the type of toilet bowl brush that you use. So I'm going to show you exactly the kind that I like, and I'll include a link below for to make sure you can access it. I found it really makes a difference in how effectively I can clean underneath the rim of the toilet. I've had a lot of cheap toilet bowl brushes that haven't lasted me very long, and I've been very pleased with this one that I have. So I'm going to start off with a baking soda scrub just to get any residue out of there, and then we'll finish it up with something to more disinfect and deodorize. Go into what I call my little chamber. I like to use the OXO brand brush. OXO makes some really great kitchen tools, but also makes some nice bathroom cleaning essentials. So this brush that I use has a nice container to hold it and keep it dry, but has a very maybe ergonomic head, I don't know, to get underneath the rim. So what I do is I scoop out a cup of baking soda, and I go ahead and do this first when I'm cleaning the bathroom so it has a chance to sit while I'm cleaning the rest of it. So a cup of baking soda, and we'll swish it around in here. Let it sit for a minute, and then I'll flush it and then put some vinegar in there actually. Let's let that sit for a second. I'm gonna come back in this way and show you. I put a cup of white vinegar in after I've finished with using the baking soda, and that's just for the inside of the bowl. If we've had a really bad stomach virus or something, I'll probably up the power a little bit inside the bowl just to make sure that everything's sparkling and a little bit more disinfected. So in that case, I might add some tea tree oil to the vinegar, maybe about a quarter of a teaspoon in with the vinegar, and let it sit there a while. The other thing I do is I will spray off my seat with a hydrogen peroxide solution and let it sit for at least 10 minutes on there. I do have one other cleaning spray that I use, and I don't have it out here. I'll pull it and show it to you probably tomorrow. But if I'm trying to disinfect in a hurry, it's a Clorox Anywhere spray. It doesn't have a smell to it, doesn't seem to be quite as toxic, but I know that it's working quickly. Hydrogen peroxide is a very effective disinfectant for just a general household use, not in probably in a hospital or something like that. But it does need to sit for about 10 minutes to disinfect. Vinegar itself at room temperature will not kill germs completely. It is a really good deodorizer, but there have been some studies done through some universities that have shown the effectiveness of hydrogen peroxide versus vinegar, and hydrogen peroxide wins hands down, so that's why I like to use that. I'll try to send that study along to you too. So now I'm gonna go ahead and flush the baking soda. Excuse me just a minute. The reason I actually flush the baking soda down is I'm not trying to get the vinegar and baking soda to react with one another. It's kind of a fun science experiment to let it bubble, but it really doesn't do anything. So I want them to work separately from one another. If you've ever made one of the volcanoes with vinegar and baking soda and it bubbles out, it's a fun thing to do with your kids, but it's not what I want to happen in my toilet. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's getting it clean just because it bubbles. It's more just turning into water. So I'm gonna put about a cup of vinegar in here. I know about how much I use, but if you are first starting out, you can measure it. And I'll just swish it around inside the bowl, and I'll let it sit for a while I'm cleaning the rest of the toilet. I'm not gonna spray down the seat and everything with hydrogen peroxide right now, but I would if I were cleaning my bathroom. So like I said, I keep this little spray bottle handy, and I just mist it over the seat, any surfaces that hands would touch or whatever. Let's move on to making our second cleaner for the bathroom. I'm gonna go ahead and make up my recipe of all-purpose spray that I use on my counters. And actually, I've even used it to clean my mirror some before I removed the coating from my mirror that I had from commercial ammonia-based cleaners. Now when I clean my mirror, I only have to use my trusty damp microfiber cloth and a white cotton tea towel. The white cotton tea towel does not have lint on it, so it's very easy to buff my mirrors dry. And if you'll take a peek, I've already done the mirrors actually, but I don't have spots or residue on there, and it works very well. So because I have a wood lining or encasing my mirror, I really don't want ammonia-based cleaners to get on that wood because they would erode it. So all it really takes is a little buffing dry and my all-purpose solution if I have any spots on my mirror, wood mirror frame. It works great for that. So let's get to making my all-purpose cleaner. For that, I use distilled water and I use Castile soap and I use some essential oils. So you know what? I told you the one rule of thumb was to keep distilled water on hand, but I left my distilled water. So we're just gonna grab some from the tap. Use 4 cups of that, which is a quart. And you can use this in any room of the house. Sometimes I change up the formulation of essential oils based upon which room I'm in, but I'm just gonna use this one for the bathroom. This all-purpose spray concoction that I'm going to make is going to have some tea tree oil in it and some orange. Because I like to use a lot of oils on my face in the evening, avocado or sweet almond oil, a lot of times I have oily residue on my counters and it leaves rings. So I need something that's gonna be a degreaser and a cleaner. So orange oil comes into play. It's a really hard hair in that way. So I have water, I have Castile soap. I'm gonna go ahead and add some of that in there. And I'll give you the exact recipe to download. I'll give you a downloadable printable recipe guide to making your household cleaners. So you can just grab that, you don't have to remember it right now. And then I'm gonna add in some tea tree oil. You'll need about 30 drops total of whatever oil that you use. I'm guessing at the moment, so I don't have to stand and drop it out for you. But you'll need about 30 drops total. So you can combine whatever you want. I have some favorites, but you might come up with your own combinations too. Stir all this together. If you have a spray bottle that's 32 ounces, you can just mix it up in there. But if you want to divide it out and to put it in several different spray bottles, you can make it up in a glass measuring pitcher. Let's do this. Watch me make a mess here. Okay. That's why I need a foam. This all-purpose cleaner works really well if you have granite or marble even in your bathroom. I have some cast iron in my sinks. It's a porcelain glaze, I believe, on there, so it's gentle for that. It's great for my counters, so I can just go ahead and spritz it on if I can and tighten it. I'm just going to spritz it on my counters and let it sit a minute or two. If you've had a lot of sickness going on in your home, I've let it sit a little bit longer. It takes a while longer for tea tree to be effective. I'm gonna let it sit there a minute. And I'm also gonna go ahead and clean my sinks. So I'm gonna grab the baking soda out of here. I'm not showing you the worst bathroom in my house, which is the mud room. And it usually has orange rings if my kids have come in and washed their hands from being out on the farm. So baking soda will take care of it in a heartbeat and is very gentle. And usually I let my little farmers take care of that chore because it's their bathroom. Here, you go ahead, I put some baking soda in the sink and get my microfiber cloth clean. And I just, and you can see, it's just very easy and effective. Wipe it out and clean that. So it's a very effective cleaner for the sink. And then I'll take another microfiber cloth and I'll just wipe down the counters here. A little bit of circular motion. You don't have to bear down very hard. Kind of elbow grease if it's really caked up. But I don't use sponges. I like to be able to wash my microfiber cloths in the washing machine. And I don't like the fact that a sponge usually harbors a lot of bacteria. So a microfiber I like better than a standard washcloth just because it helps me get a little bit of the, attract some of the grease and dirt. But if you just need to use some old washcloth or even a cotton tea towel, you could do that too. So I'm going to show you a little bit about the mirror, what I mean. I'm going to get another clean. Make sure you're using a clean microfiber cloth when you do the mirror. I usually clean the mirror the last thing just because I might be splashing something, knowing me. So I have a few little spots here from someone was brushing their teeth or something in this area. I'm just going to go in a circular motion here, and you'll notice it leaves a little bit of a sheen. So I want to immediately buff that dry with my white cotton tea towel, and it takes a second, but the water will generally disappear. Just buff it completely dry. It won't hurt anything. I know that there are some recipes out there for a cleaner that uses some alcohol to help dissolve and evaporate the water a little bit more quickly. I've done that in the past, but honestly, I've gotten to the point where just water is enough for me, so I think, why waste the effort of making something extra? So, the last place that we'll have to do is the shower, and I think some of you mentioned that shower is your least favorite part to clean, and I can agree. We have a huge master shower, and one of the hardest places for me to get is the grout. We have colored grout, and so I cannot use bleach on there. And for a long time, I didn't know what to do to get the grout clean. And so we have a few long-standing little stains in the corner from some mildew. The bathroom is a really horrible place that traps moisture. So one of the things that we have is a moisture-sensing exhaust fan, and it senses how much moisture is in the room. You can actually adjust the level of moisture that you want to stay in the room. It comes on automatically throughout the day, and that helps us to maintain our moisture level a little bit better. But the more moist your bathroom is, the more likely you're to grow mold and bacteria. And you really don't want that, because it can wreak havoc with your health. So, one of the things that I found is that vodka will actually kill the root of the mildew. Now, some people use bleach, but bleach apparently does not actually kill all the mildew. Vodka is the one thing that will get to the root of it. So I add vodka to a spray bottle, and I spritz that in my shower, and you can either spray it and scrub it right away. You can let it sit for about 30 minutes and then scrub it. So usually I'll spritz this on, and I'll let it sit for a little bit if I'm kind of getting ready in the morning and not ready to clean, and then I will come back and I'll scrub my shower after that. Usually what I'll do, because the alcohol is pretty much evaporated, I'll go ahead and just sprinkle in some baking soda into my shower again. Like I told you, I use baking soda for everything. There we go. If I feel like I have a lot to scrub out of the bathroom, the other thing sometimes I'll mix in with my baking soda is a little bit of table salt. You know, the cheap table salt that you don't want to put in your food very much, not the good sea salt. I just grab a bottle of that, like the generic store brand, and sprinkle a little bit of that along with my baking soda in the shower. It gives me a little bit of extra elbow grease to get any clay dirt stains out of there. Now, thankfully, I have dark colored tile, but I have some other bathrooms in the house that have a little bit more of a porcelain type tub or something like that, and it's helpful to have a little bit of extra scrubbing power to go with it. So, unlike that green stuff in the can that you shake from a can and the fumes get to your nose, baking soda is a lot more friendly. So I'll just sprinkle baking soda on the floor of my shower, and I'll just give it a good scrub, and if I cleaned it recently, it doesn't take me very long. On the shower walls, I'll also use my all-purpose cleaner, spritz it down, and wipe it down. I do have one other shower cleaner recipe that I will give to you. In the download, it has a few extra heavy hitting ingredients, including some borax. So I'll give that to you later on if you especially have some soap scum that you're dealing with. But a lot of times my all-purpose cleaner will do the trick. So sometimes I also add a little bit extra of two certain essential oils to my vodka if I've had a lot of trouble with mold and mildew that month. Or if I've put off cleaning the shower for a little bit longer than I should have, and those give a little bit extra power to clean some of that mold and mildew. Let's see. If you have any other questions about problems in your bathroom, drop me a line, comment below, and let's see what we can do to help you enjoy your spring clean naturally in the bathroom. Thanks, and here's to Holtsome.